Now, we have both listened to Rob Zombie.
Yeah.
Quite a lot.
Guilty.
Love it. Love it. But I have never seen any of his music videos. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Arsenic and Espresso, a podcast where we rarely drink coffee, but we always talk about
metal music. And tonight, we're reacting to metal music and drinking coffee. But it is
Halloween
season. So we figured, why not react to
some Halloween classics? Now, we have both listened to Rob Zombie.
Yeah.
Quite a lot.
Guilty.
Love it. Love it. But I have never seen any of his music videos. If you watched our Type O Negative reaction, then you know I don't watch any music videos for any band ever. True. And I want to say I was like 11 or 12 the first time I heard Rob Zombie. And I have never once thought to look up a music video to any of his stuff.
Yeah, I haven't seen the music video either. But it's also been a while since I've listened to any of his stuff, so it'll be a nice review.
I listen to Rob Zombie on the regular.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. All right, well then, let's just get into it. So this won't be a reaction, but it will be a review?
It will be a reaction to the video. The video. We are reacting to Living Dead Girl by Rob Zombie, the music video. It's one of my favorite Rob Zombie songs.
It's so good.
And without further ado,
let's get into the review.
Maybe. Where's the thing up on the thing?
No, it's not. Without further ado, now we can get in to the review.
Who is this irresistible?
But, first off, I like that they're having a like old school horror movie take on it.
Mm-hmm.
Filming the whole, like the Type O Negative video. If you look at this aspect ratio of the video, you can tell that it was shot a while back.
Yeah. I mean, this video was uploaded 11 years ago. The video was probably filmed.
When was, look up really quick when this.
We can look up when.
That's got to be like.
It was released in 1998.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's been around for a while.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
Oh, it's done in like a silent film style. That's why the words are there. Oh, I love that. Gather around, non-believers, and witness a miracle.
That right there, the devil's wing, that always threw me off because I was like, it has to rhyme with down.
And then it doesn't.
And it doesn't. And it always drives me nuts. I don't think that he gets enough credit for what he's done to the metal scene. I mean, the whole, like, you get the synthesizer in there, which kind of inspired, like, the Cell Dwellers and other bands like that.
Yes.
And then, like, nobody heard that music for a long time, and now, like, every other metalcore band is doing it and adding it into their stuff, and people are like, oh my gosh, blowing my mind. This is ridiculous.
You're like, this isn't new.
Not new at all, but I still dig it. So let's go.
Again, in our Type O Negative video, I said I love the like super classic horror style of filming with the lighting, and this being done in the style of like a 1920s silent film, mm-hmm. and having that same style,
yeah,
as Nosferatu,
yeah,
right, which we were also talking about in the Type O Negative video. Anyway, super like it.
Get to the rooftop. This machine creates another fiend so beautiful they make you kill.
I love that silent film style.
That was done so well.
That was done so well. I've definitely, now that I have seen the video beginning to end, I've definitely seen clips of it.
Yeah.
Here and there.
Did he do this before he started directing?
I don't know when he started directing films. His first solo song was in 96. Oh, written and performed with Alice Cooper. That's dope.
That is cool.
Studio album Hellbilly Deluxe in 98. Ah, and then Zombie directed the horror film House of a Thousand Corpses in 2000. So yes, okay. This was written before his directorial debut.
Cool. Okay. Yeah. So that was, I think that was super fitting. I'm really.
Go ahead.
No. Okay.
You go. You're really what?
No, I'm really loving all of the videos that have been set to old horror film.
Yeah.
And how well they've been executed. I think it's been great.
Classic horror is some of my favorite. You want a lyric breakdown?
Yes.
Right. Who is this irresistible creature who has an insatiable lust for the dead? Living dead girl. Rage in the cage and piss upon the stage. There's only one sure way to bring the giant down. Defunct the strings of cemetery things with one flat foot on the devil's wing. Crawl on me, sink into me, die for me, living dead girl. Crawl on me, sink into me, die for me, living dead girl. What?
Okay. So now reading the lyrics, mm-hmm. I see where the rhyme is, mm-hmm. with wing and things, right?
Yes.
But
because it's sung on a different tempo.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
Yep.
Raping the geek and hustling the freak like a hunchback juice on a sentimental noose. Operation Filth, they love to love the wealth of an SS whore making scary sounds. Crawl on me, sink into me, die for me, living dead girl. Crawl on me, sink into me, die for me, living dead girl. Cyclone Jack, hallucinating hack, thinks that Donna Reed eats dollar bills. Goldfoot's machine creates another fiend, so beautiful, they make you kill. Crawl on me, sink into me, die for me, living dead girl. Crawl on me, sink into me, die for me, living dead girl. Blood on her skin, dripping with sin, do it again. Living dead girl. Blood on her skin, dripping with sin. Do it again. Living dead girl. I love this song so much. This is honestly one of my favorite Rob Zombie songs.
He had a handful of singles that were like hits, mm-hmm. from that first album that he did. Mm-hmm. And all of them were great. That whole album's pretty darn good.
We should do a Rob Zombie discography. Thank you for joining us on this spooky evening. Check out the link in our bio. We have our mugs for our first 1,000 subscribers, if you so choose to get one. They're pretty dope. They hold coffee nice and well. I was going to say something else, and I don't remember what it was. So I guess that's all.